tan theta upon 1 minus cot theta plus cot theta upon 1 minus tan theta. Our first step will be converting all ratios in terms of sine theta or cos theta. So we have sine theta upon cos theta, that is tan theta, and cos theta upon sine theta is cot theta. Same thing, cos theta upon sine theta, 1 minus sine theta upon cos theta. Now taking LCM in denominator, here sine theta upon cos theta as it is, this will be sine theta minus cos theta upon sine theta, and in second term cos theta upon sine theta as it is, cos theta minus sine theta upon cos theta. Now we have fraction in numerator as well as in denominator. So the denominator of the denominator will go in numerator, and denominator of numerator will go in denominator. Same thing in the second term. So what we will have, sine square theta upon cos theta into sine theta minus cos theta. Second term we will have cos square theta upon sine theta into cos theta minus sine theta. Now if we take out minus sign common from this bracket, this plus will become minus. Cos square theta as it is, sine theta will remain as it is, and inside the bracket it will become sine theta minus cos theta, because minus sign we have taken common. First term will remain as it is. This we have done because now you can observe this bracket is same in both the terms, so it becomes easier in taking LCM. Now entire LCM will be this bracket, theta and the bracket. So sine theta is missing, so multiply this fraction by sine theta, whereas here we are having sine theta and bracket, so multiply by cos theta. Now we will have sine cube theta minus cos cube theta. apply the formula for a cube plus minus b cube in numerator. It will be a minus b into bracket a square plus ab plus b square. Denominator will be as it is, sine theta minus cos theta into cos theta into sine theta. Now we have one bracket common, so cancelling that bracket, and sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1. Using that identity, numerator will become 1 plus sin theta into cos theta, and denominator will be cos theta into sin theta. Now separating the denominator, we have 1 upon cos theta into sin theta plus sin theta into cos theta upon cos theta into sin theta. And we know the reciprocal of 1 upon cos theta and 1 upon sin theta, that is sec theta and cosec theta, and the second term will become 1. Now if you check, this is our required right hand side. 1 plus sec theta into cosec theta. Hence this is our